tell a nigga get this money. Ran through 20, she keep coming. Fuck few times, lil' mom keep coming. Send code, then you finna fuck my stomach. Home get it gone from Monday to Sunday. Don't know what he said, but it smell like a onion. Rounds in the gun, baby, bitch keep coming. I got blue presidents in my jeans. My big dog in a whole nother league. She be calling me back when I leave. You said for me, huh? We got brown, I be clean.
Hey, off the rip, we finally got the audio fixed. My mic finally came in, bro. I finally got the little roll mic. Now, some of y'all probably didn't even notice the difference. Some people probably didn't even pay attention to it. You know what I'm saying? But just me listening to the video sometimes, it'll sound like loud and echoish. You feel me? In my old spot, I used to have acoustic phone pads or acoustic, however y'all want to call it. I used to have a phone pads around, so I had to go get me a little mic. I went to like 6 different stores, my nigga. None of them had it in stock, so I just ordered that bit on Amazon. Anyway, we finna get right to the video. We got my boy Tommy G, Pimps and Prostitutes of Los Angeles. I think I reacted to 1 to 4 videos on my second channel. Make sure y'all go subscribe over there, because that's where I'm going to be doing majority of the music at over here. I'm going to try to keep it. We just going to react. We just going to react, my nigga. You feel me? So let's knock the video out. Y'all don't know, I'm from Houston, Texas. I don't know if this was pimping was originated, my nigga, but this is what this shit was verified at. It was stamped at. You feel me? Like, hey, man, if you know, you know. You feel me? When it come to Houston, hey, we notorious. I feel like we like first on the list, like notorious for pimping, no cap. So this ain't nothing new to me. It ain't finna be nothing I ain't seen in real life type shit. You feel me? Like in the back seat, my mama driving, so I look down the street. Shout it, I'm 5 years old. No, I'm keep realistic. I'm about 9 years old. Shout it outside. Hey, nigga, they cold as hell. I'm like, damn, shout it. You know what I'm saying? Cheap do look cool though, but damn, you feel me? 9 years old, I'm just keeping it 100. But let's get to the video, bro. He be making some good ass video. Off the rip, it is Mother's Day, so shout out to all the mothers. Hoping y'all having a beautiful day. All my young niggas, hoping y'all have a good day. If you watching this video, I hope you having a good day. You feel me? So let's get into the video, man. I ain't even gonna talk too much. Y'all boys, let's get it, man.
Now I'm round looking rich.
It be barely started, I ain't gonna lie. I ain't really for it, bro. You feel me? Like, the crazy part is, you asked my dog D Mill, bro. I could have been pimping, my nigga. I had a few females, I chopped it up, got into their ear. I'm a rapper, bro, so my mouthpiece crazy. I freestyle, my mouthpiece off the top, stupid. I done talked to a shot, would've got outside for me, but if you know about pimping, my hoe would've got knocked, bro, because I don't be outside. They would've took my hoe, and I'm in the crib, like, so. But I ain't really for it, bro. Like, I feel like they could be doing something with their life, but let's see what they talking about.
I want to know what the hell is going on before we go too close to this whatever dog.
Now I'm round looking rich. Yeah. I'm still round with that stick. Let her op run him down, swear you getting flipped. Blah. It's crazy now I walk inside the mall, got all these people trying to stop me and take pics.
I'm fucking nervous.
This nigga funny, though. I ain't gonna lie.
Prostitution, a reality of our world that we prefer to brush under the rug or pretend it doesn't exist. But the fact is, prostitution has been around since the beginning of recorded history. Pimps, prostitutes, johns, and the justice system, the main characters in this complicated story. In this episode, we dig deep.
He had 3 niggas and 1 female on the little picture.
Refer to the topic of prostitution as we become possibly the first ever documentary channel to pick up prostitution. In this episode, we dig deeper into the topic of prostitution.
Shout it out here. I'm talking about naked from top to bottom.
As we become crazy. Possibly the first ever documentary channel to pick up prostitutes and interview them about their life. Join us as we go boots on the ground in South Central Los Angeles.
What say boots on the ground?
No. Touch my eyes, just so I know.
Boy, I had
to see this firsthand on the street.
That's crazy, so though. Honestly, I'm gonna keep it 100, bro. I don't really know how to feel, fool, because it's like some of them female, they do look cool, but it's just like, it's like you can't be attracted to them, bro, because it just feel like it's dirty. That's just my opinion. That's probably a little prop to watching the video. Look at a shot. I ain't talking, I'm just going out without my nigga. I can only imagine so much. You feel me? You outside, you getting your cheek clapped every day. Some niggas dirty, some niggas funky. All you care about is the price. It's like, you can be bad at here all day, but I'm big on hygiene, fool. So it's like, it's hard to let that slide. You feel me? You can look like the baddest in the world, but it kind of like, I don't know. It feel weird. Like, you feel me?
So normal? That's what we're going to explore.
That nigga put a goddamn Cardi B type beat on the back.
I can't believe how many of them there are. This is so out in the open. Like, there's not even, like, a slight attempt to disguise what's going on.
Oh, my gosh.
We've been driving for, like, 30 minutes. Okay. Every couple blocks, we see a prostitute. I have seen not one police car yet. Oh, there's our first. I wonder what the police mentality is towards prostitution.
I wonder what that scripted right there.
They're not serious about it. Maybe it's, as long as the girls are safe, they let it go. Because I doubt they're going to stop next to any of these girls in the corner. I'm Tommy. I'm here with...
Kati.
We noticed a lot of women out. How long has that been normal for?
Shit, it's not normal.
No.
And now they passed the law, it's even better.
Yeah? What was the law they passed?
Shit, females can make their money.
Really?
That's crazy. Los Angeles, they... That's crazy, bro. Y'all law is crazy, because in Texas, nigga, like I said, bro, Houston and Bissonnette is notorious for that, nigga. You go to Bissonnette Street for it's females everywhere. You know what I'm saying? So, but it also be having signs, like, they got signs when you getting towards that area that'll tell you, hey, this is a first class felony. This is a felony. Blah, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying? So, niggas I don't really know, but I would guess niggas don't be on it, because it's like, felony signs around that bit. You feel me? Right here, Shotty saying they done made it legal. Y'all nigga, I don't know y'all gun laws in California. I think they terrible. They like New York. Y'all niggas can't have protection, but hoes can, thots can be outside getting paid to get their cheeks clout. That's crazy. Because in Texas, we got some of the best gun laws ever, nigga. Everybody got, you think it's bad. It's not bad because you niggas know not to f*** with you. They know they life in danger. Nigga come up and rob, you come rob anything out here, you getting shot at, for sure. You better run up to that bit with your gun drawn, because you're going to get shot. For sure, I love it, too. I love it. I love that.
Really? I'm getting arrested.
So is it decriminalized?
Yeah.
Kind of like weed is in the last states? Really? Okay, when did they change that?
This year. So you might see a whole lot of crazy shit out here, naked girls.
That's crazy.
Out here,
really?
Because
and they have no worry?
No, we don't get in trouble no more. You don't get in trouble no more.
We don't get in trouble. Shout out to all of us.
Is it safe for the women?
You have to be careful. Because you had Johns pull up like they want a date and half of them be trying to rob you. So no, it's not safe. It's always to be with a pair or have you protection.
And would you classify a pimp as a good person, a bad person, or?
A pimp is a person with low self-esteem.
What makes you say that?
Why would you need a female to make your money? Why you can't make your own money? Our money is our money. Why we got to sell our body to give it to you or get beat up for not giving you our money?
Yeah.
Hey, I'm gonna keep it 100 though. I got mixed opinions, dog. Cause look, of course, I feel like a lot of them females out there could easily go get them a dude. You feel me? Like, nigga, shit, half of the nigga, if you that, like, let's say Shawty feel like she got low self-esteem or she down, she don't really feel like she worth nothing. Shit, the nigga that coming to pay you, he feel like he needs somebody to talk to him. He lame as hell, he wants somebody to talk, he ready to pay $50. Shit, why don't y'all just start dating? That's just how I feel. It clearly ain't about looks or what you like, because you're getting paid for it. So just get you one of these niggas. That's just my opinion. But, you know, to touch up on what they just said, I feel like pimps are important if you're going to be a hoe, bro. I'm going to just be 100, because it is niggas out there that'll do you bad. The world is crazy, bro. Y'all in a dangerous game. See, these little weirdo niggas, they be having to plot and come kidnap people and do little weird shit. They got to plot and try not to get caught. Y'all promoting yourself, like, it's kind of easy for them. Like, I get in the car with you, you give me $100, you go to this destination, now boom. Nigga then took your ass to Nebraska somewhere and nobody keeping up with you. We don't know where you was at. You gone. But if you got a pimp, your pimp right on the street, he the one going to stand on 10 and come, hey, bro, you feel me? Like, that's just what I feel. I don't know about the money part. But shit, they need to get compensated for their work. You feel me? Shit, hey. Both parties, though. The females, too. So that's why I said that's just my opinion, man. I feel like female need to get paid. She doing the work. Homie need to get paid. He doing the work. We need to come on some goddamn joint contract or some shit.
What percent of the cut you feel like a pimp usually takes in this situation? 100%.
They take it all.
And what makes that worth it for the woman to be involved in?
I guess if you like the person, you just need the money to survive out here.
I noticed you got some protection on you. There's...
Stay ready, you ain't got to get ready.
Have you ever had to use those?
Yeah, at that stand on the feet.
Is there a lot?
You don't need more than some brass knuckle, little mama. You don't like, you got no speed to you. You throw that brass knuckle, I'm gonna weed him up, hit you with a strong 2P combo. Gonna think I'm Javonte Davis when I hit you with these bitches. I'm talking about I'm gonna hit you so goddamn hard, fool, that goddamn brass knuckle you gonna think I was wearing. You gonna need a gun? Some pepper spray, you need to get out of California, come to Texas. They done made the wrong goddamn thing legal down there. They need, you can come on down here. That brass knuckle ain't gonna get you nowhere, shot. I got some permanent brass knuckles right here. You feel me? You gotta get out of there.
A competition amongst women in the Johns?
Yeah.
Describe that for us.
Because everybody feel threatened. Might have one female been out here 10 years and say I walk up and ain't been out here but a day and I pull in more Johns than she do, I would be a problem.
Where's the cost? Where's someone's?
It's $75.
Four.
That's gonna cover the room and the conversation. Most Johns just want somebody to listen to them. They all the time don't want sex. They just need somebody to vent.
So a lot of these are just lonely men that want to talk.
That's it, have a little fun. They have wives at home, but you know that.
That's crazy, bro.
The wife's not entertainment.
Right, well, thank you so much. This lady mentions that things are decriminalized completely.
Yeah,
tell
like,
us about that.
They did some shit. They passed a bill. The dude,
make sure I'm
the governor, Gavin Newsom what? Or something, to where basically the bitches can get their money. They might be cited out, but they're not going to take them to the county jail.
So it's basically sex work is decriminalized.
Yes, in California.
Really? How much does that change things?
The hoes don't gotta worry about getting harassed. You know what I'm saying? They can hoe in peace.
So yeah, you think that's a positive improvement for
yeah,
them?
Yeah,
yeah,
I see
because
it all over
a lot of time, like these cops, they don't be wanna do that hella paperwork for some shit that's really, they call it the world's oldest profession. You know what I'm saying? So if it's really the world's oldest profession, let these bitches be pros about they hoeing.
Later that night, we found a pimp who's willing to talk to us. So this is us speaking with him in the back of a car somewhere in Los Angeles. I'm Tommy and I'm here with...
They call me Joint Face for the record. You know, I'm out here, you know, high pursuit for a hoe, you know.
So what's it like?
Oh,
shit. Nigga like Blueface. Like tattoo, the way his tattoo placed. Not necessarily his face, but the way his tattoo placed, nigga look like Blueface. That made me think Blueface. Hey, bro, you pimping? Blueface probably pimping, nigga. Oh, yeah, he was pimping. Hey, think about it. Think about that nigga lingo, man. Hey, he was pimping, bro.
You know, right now, lately, you know, I just got out of prison. Had like five toes, you feel me?
What made you get into this in the first
place? Five toes?
You know, I learned from the 304, you feel me? The 304 is a
hoe, you feel
me? And I learned from my auntie, you feel me? She was a vet, you feel me, that shit. She taught me all the game. I was doing square shit, you feel me? Boyfriend shit, you know, shit that I'm supposed to be doing, you feel me?
Why are you supposed to be doing that?
Because I'm a pimp, you feel me? I'm a big 16, you feel me? And we don't hold hands and kick hands, you feel me?
Would you say you ever had like a soft and loving relationship with a woman before? Like a woman that you can just hold and love?
Not square, you feel me?
Why does that make someone a square?
That nigga said I'm not a square, you feel me? Hell nah.
I did that already. Got my heart broken a long time ago. Bitch will never get it again.
The main
thing I always tell a bitch.
Heartbreaks ain't no joke. Hey, I'm gonna stop pausing my fault, fool. But them heartbreak. But them heartbreak will make your head go future. They'll make you go pimp for real. Like, hey, y'all don't let them female play with y'all like that, bro.
All you got is your word, your pussy, and your respect. Without that, you ain't shit, bitch.
It seems to me like this would be a very dangerous job for the women. What do you do to make sure that they are safe?
You know, I don't do no babysitting, but you feel me? When the bitch call me and tell me nigga tripping, you know, I trip by mine, you feel me? I'm gonna pull up on a nigga and tell a nigga let the bitch breathe, you feel me? Let the bitch get the dough, you feel me? Especially the bitch in pocket, you feel me?
Is there any stereotypes about the John, like their age, their race? Are they married? Are they divorced? Like, tell me about what a John looks like.
A Mexican. Don't date blacks. No, that's not a John. Mexican.
Wait, why not a black?
Cause they be on weird shit. Rape, rob, kidnap, all kinds of shit, you know?
An ideal
that nigga said a black people be tripping. Okay, so he said Mexicans. That's crazy.
Or someone that's Mexican or white.
Yeah, old season one.
So basically a lonely man.
Yeah, lonely man. He might got a relationship, he just getting tired of bullshit pussy at the home.
What percentage of these men you think are married?
Probably 50.
Some people would say, man, a pimp, that's a bad person. He's mistreating women. It's a really bad situation. What do you say about that?
I say them people, It sounds stupid.
Yeah. Why is that?
That's the person that gives you instructions, your teacher, your guardian. I mean, that's everything to you. I mean, that's daddy.
So you view the pimp, the role of the pimp as a positive one?
Yeah, that's positive. How boyfriend, so? That's not positive.
And can you explain that further?
The reason why the boy...
Hell nah! That nigga say boyfriend, that's not positive. Man, this nigga here, bro. I'm finna hear him out though. What you gotta say, fool? He might got a point, but let me see something.
What percentage of these men you think are married?
Probably 50.
Some people would say, man, a pimp, that's a bad person. He's mistreating women. It's a really bad situation. What do you say about that?
I say them people, they sound stupid.
Yeah? Why is that?
That's the person that gives you instructions, your teacher, your guardian. I mean, that's everything to you. I mean, that's daddy.
So you view the pimp, the role of the pimp as a positive one?
Yeah, that's positive. How boyfriend, so? That's not positive.
And can you explain that further?
The reason why the boyfriend ain't positive is because he might be a mark, might be a buster, he might be too soft for the bitch, you feel me?
That nigga say he may be a mark and a buster. God dang, fool. Hold on, bro. D. Kelly nigga funny, dog.
The role of the pimp is a positive one.
Yeah, that's positive. How boyfriend, so? That's not positive.
And can you explain that further?
The reason why the boyfriend ain't positive is because he might be a mark, might be a buster, might be too soft for this bitch, you feel me? This is like niggas with glasses and niggas that run this shit, you feel me? Soft niggas get run over, it ain't gonna be any good because the bitch gonna run over you all day, you feel me?
Hey, that facts, but you ain't gotta be no pimp to be aggressive or run the situation, homie, you feel me? Like, I'ma just keep it 100. Soft niggas do get ran over. These females funny because they want a nigga to be all babyish and this and that. But y'all be them niggas getting ran over. If you want a female DM right now and you text her good morning, beautiful, or she post a picture and you just can't hold your comment to yourself, you gotta say something, she might pull the little cheeks on up. She might have a little cheek laying out on the beach or something. You know what I'm saying? Probably got a camera like these right here. Got the cheek right up. And you see the picture and go back to the video 5 times. Damn, child. And you can't go about your business. You can't just let it slide. Okay, she look cool. Go about. You got it. Damn, baby, you look beautiful. Like, why don't you come spend a day with me? Let me take you out some. It's some nigga around here that probably didn't double, that hearted the story and went on about his business. Probably didn't even go hard story. Now she on him. Then he probably, when they get talk, he probably for sure dry texting him. She on him. But you text him. Yeah, every time she hit you, what you doing? You send up a paragraph. What about you? A paragraph. Like, homie, just chill. Y'all nigga ran over. So I didn't want somebody that ain't stunning her. But my daddy always told me, so young nigga, women want what they can't have. You treat them female like she's just right here. Not downgrade her, but just treat her like you like her, but chill. You gonna get her. But if you treat her like she just mean the world, she gonna treat you like I mean the world and your little ass better stay in place, nigga. You feel me? So I feel him right there, but.
Have you ever felt bad for one of your bitches?
I never felt bad for a bitch. Cause I ain't never did nothing wrong to the bitch, you feel me? I bossed the bitch up, you feel me? She bossed me up and I bossed her up. That's how every time it happened.
So one of the things you've heard is that the pimps take a lot, if not all of the money from.
Yeah, I take all the money.
So how is that bossing up her?
I'm buying everything. I'm her like a bank account. If she needs something, come get it from me, bitch. She a reflection of me. I want my bitch looking gooder than me.
Is it an aspect
of control? It sounds like it, though. But what if she come back and say she want to bust down Cartier and that bitch 30,000? And she run up her numbers. 15 nigga done clapped the cheeks this week. She done made 30,000, bro. It probably, I'm giving y'all I'm rough estimate. Probably 400 niggas done clapped the cheeks in the last 2 months. She done ran up 60,000. She come text you, hey man, I want that bust down Cartier. You gonna say, all right, let's go get it? Or you gonna be like, hell nah, not right now. Let me know, man. If you a pimp and you watching this, let me know, man. I'm trying to know.
Well, like, what makes you get all the money when she's doing all the work?
Cause I was out there risking my life. I was out there sweating this blade just like her. I was down just like her, you know what I'm saying?
Do you have any daughters?
Yeah.
So if your daughter went out,
he said that's so disappointing.
With the blade, would you be mad at her, disappointed, happy?
Hey, running back, look how he said, yeah, I'm gonna stop pausing. That time, my fault, I'm done for real.
Me, bitch. She a reflection of me. I want my bitch looking gooder than me.
Is it an aspect of control? Like, what makes you get all the money when she's doing all the work?
Because I was out there risking my life. I was out there sweating this blade just like her. I was down just like her, you know what I'm saying?
Do you have any daughters?
Yeah.
So if your daughter went out and worked the block, worked the blade, would you be mad at her, disappointed, happy.
Yeah, I'd be mad as a motherfucker.
Yeah.
But, and I did it to the gang of people's daughters and all type of shit too, so I'd be like, damn, can't be a hypocrite.
Well, I know you gotta get back to what you're doing. Appreciate it. So when there's a prostitute.
And yeah, nah, I ain't shaking your hand, nigga. But y'all have been touching elephant ass and all kinds of shit. I ain't touching your hand, boy. Hell wrong with you. Alright, cool. I'm fuck with you, bro. Elbow is there. Ain't shaking hand, nigga.
The pimp nearby. And for what we know about pimps, they're looking for ways to make money the easiest way. If I was a pimp and I saw me walking around, I would rob the shit out of me. You guys tell me in the
who
comments,
wouldn't,
should sex work be legalized? Should it be criminalized? I'm interested to see what you think. How you doing? I'm a documentary filmmaker, can I ask you any questions? Okay. Be safe out here, okay? One thing that makes these documentaries hard is my face looks like a cop. I look like a rookie at the academy. I look like an undercover cop. No wonder these ladies are sketchy.
Nah, you don't look undercover. You look very over the cover, nigga. You look like a cop for real, bro.
How you doing?
Oh, that's a camera. He pulled out
the... Oh, sorry. It's great, though. Hello.
I'm a documentary filmmaker, Joanne. Can I ask you any questions? Okay. Be safe out here, okay? One thing that makes these documentaries hard is my face looks like a cop. I look like a rookie at the academy. I look like an undercover cop. No wonder these ladies are sketched out by me.
Officer Brian, Officer Ramirez. That fits you.
How you doing?
Oh, that's a camera. He pulled out the...
We're calling it for tonight. We
stressed
our luck.
Personality on point two.
Some toots. And we're going to try our luck tomorrow morning. Stay tuned.
Good ad placement. I ain't even mad at you. I like that.
You're not ready for it.
So it's cold here this morning. It's probably 55 degrees. And you gotta imagine that anyone that's still out lingering right now, they still need to make more money before they can go back home. Otherwise their pimps can be upset that 50 to 100 bucks for a conversation and a warm car is probably a good option. So never thought I'd be at an ATM getting money for prostitutes. Speaking of money, there's a 100% chance that YouTube is demonetizing this episode. If you feel inclined to support my Patreon, I would very much appreciate it.
I feel like realistically, no pimp is awake right now. These girls are pretty much on their own at this point in the morning. These pimps have been out, they've been drinking, smoking, doing pills until 2, 3 a.m. They're crashed out.
I have a police officer face, and that's a stereotype I'm trying to shake. All right, guys, this is it. We're always going the extra mile to bring you the raw shit at home. I'm gonna try and convince them to hop in the backseat with me and just have a conversation. Let's see how it goes.
Hey, Tommy, come get some of the, come shout with the brand, bro. You say you look like 12, I'll put you in the brand, my nigga. And that's also a promo right there. Good promo. Ooh. Hey, I'm gonna give y'all that code day one, like I told y'all. It's probably gonna last one more day. You get 10% off. I'm gonna make 2 day ones though. I'll probably put like day one with an exclamation point if I can. I'm gonna put the code right here. 1 for 15% off if you shop more items, and then 1 for $10 off. But it's day one, bro.
When you get nervous sometimes, your body's like, oh god, here we go.
Hey sir, do we look like undercover police officers?
Okay, good.
Hey, we are on
Figueroa right now. So we're keeping our eyes peeled for high heels, high skirts, and low morals.
You say low morals.
How you doing this morning? Good. No? I got cash.
Should've said that first.
That was my first time trying to pick up a prostitute and I failed.
So I think what
stop
I
lying.
Is flash the
mic. Hey, Thomas, stop lying, boy. We know your ass. Ever since you played Grand Theft Auto and got one from the strip club, nigga, we knew your ass tried it in real life a long time ago, Tommy. We know you got 5 of them on roll call in your call outs, nigga. Stop lying, boy. Your ass a pro at this, boy. That's why you knew exactly where to go. Boy, I don't want to hear that shit.
I think money talks. You gotta have our approach a little more.
I think that was good.
I think it's just gonna be a numbers game.
Why little bro?
Old ass white dudes can
pause.
Do it. I can too. Oh,
I'm fucking
nervous. My little bro seat all the way touching the steering wheel.
I'm good. So we're looking for like 5-10 minutes of asking your questions, and then you'll be on your way. And I got a ski mask if you want to wear one.
Whatever you feel comfortable with, we just want to ask you some questions.
What do you go by?
Maya.
Maya. Okay, so you're a beautiful woman here on a Saturday morning. What does life look like for you?
It has its days. It could be
a lot going on, and it could be nothing going on.
Here's what I think. If I was in your shoes, I think I'd be scared a lot. Like, even getting into a car with three guys could be a really big risk, right?
Right.
What's, like, has anything ever gone down that was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe this happened?
Are you talking about as far as a date?
Yeah, like a date gone wrong. Has that ever happened to you?
Yeah, quite a few times, actually.
And tell us a story, like, what happened?
I got in the car, everything was, like, all perfectly fine. Like, he was nice.
Hey, this my last time. I apologize, bro. I got to, though. Ain't no one here. Maybe it's a rental. Maybe it's a rental. But, Shabby, ain't no one here you finna sit them little patty cakes on my seat. Ain't no way. Ain't no way. We need to put some newspaper down, some goddamn doggy pads. We need to put something down. Whatever we got, it needs to go right there. Footies, whatever. Ain't no way here she's sitting them little patty pancakes on my seat. Yo hadn't been out here all morning. You got on a leather jacket with nothing below. Like, no, hell nah. We need a goddamn newspaper. Nah, shawty.
Like, the nicest person ever. Like, it was all... He was older, and we went driving down the street, and he just pulled out a knife on me. And like, oh, you're not getting out the car. He's like holding it up to my neck. Like,
what did he want from you?
He wanted head.
Down that was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe this happened.
Are you talking about as far as the date?
Yeah, like a date gone wrong. Has that ever happened to you?
Yeah, quite a few times, actually.
And tell us a story, like, what happened?
I got in the car, everything was, like, all perfectly fine. Like, he was nice, like, the nicest person ever. Like, it was all, he was older, and we went driving down the street, and he just pulls out a knife on me. And, like, oh, you're not getting out the car. He's, like, holding it up to my neck.
What did he want from you?
He wanted head. That's what he wanted. He wanted head, but he didn't want to pay for it.
So, another thing I thought about with that is your body's got to hurt. I've never given head before. Can I imagine? But if I imagine doing it a few times a day.
Pause, Tom.
Long jaw a few times.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What is that like?
It's... I've been doing this for quite a while. But before, it never happened.
How old are you?
I'm 19.
Quite a while.
Yeah.
So, you started young. Mm-hmm. Okay. What got you into the business? Like, who recruited you?
I was in foster care.
Yeah.
It was like two different occasions because one was...
That be the story too, bro. Like, they upbringing. Sometimes it be they upbringing. Sometimes it be lack of love in the crib. Sometimes it be like not having that security or people not making you feel beautiful. Like, and that's true, fool. Like, everybody tough nowadays, but like, you gotta think, nigga, we all human. We all was built with emotions and... Some of us may be, we may got tougher skin. Some stuff may not get to us like it gets to the next person, but we all got emotions. So like, Shawty may have been in a household where she didn't feel like, you know, comfortable in her skin. Like somebody didn't make her feel comfortable. And then she probably got in high school and then the dudes weren't looking at her no more. Nowadays, they looking at the BBL. So they weren't looking at her no more. So now it's like she jumped out here in this field where it feel like it's love, it's temporary, it's for money, but it's making you feel wanted. It feel like you got something to give somebody. So that's what they run it at. But it's crazy, bro, because a lot of these females, like, this ain't even got to be their case. You feel me? Their situation.
And that was in foster care. And then
did she recruit you because she was out doing it and she recruited
yeah,
you?
Yeah, but it was online. She was posting her, and then I ended up getting posted.
Is your daddy awake right now? Like, does he know what's up right now?
He's awake.
Because our number one thing when we thought about doing this is, like, the last thing we want is a goddamn pimp running us down and trying to get us. But so this is another thing that comes to mind. You're dressed like this and it's cold out. What is that like walking the block when it's this cold out?
It's bad. And sometimes I feel like it's a mind over matter.
Enjoy?
I'll be like, mind over matter. If you don't mind, it don't matter. But sometimes I'm like, fuck that shit, I mind. And I'll catch myself getting an attitude or whatnot. But other than that, it's just a thing that you kind of sort of get used to.
You lined up a visit?
Huh?
You lined up a customer?
No, I kind of have to...
Get going soon?
Yeah, I gotta, yeah.
Okay, can I ask you two more questions?
Okay.
What percent of pimps would you say are good people and what percent are shit?
My camera didn't maxed out in the middle of the video, but... let me see how I'm gonna do this. Let me start recording real quick and then start right back and we gonna pick up right there. Alright, y'all boys are in the middle. Let's get him in.
I'm so sorry. I'm not trying to set you guys up or nothing like that. I just, yeah.
Who is that, by the way?
Dang, you're nosy.
Well, I just know that if anyone's getting us, it's a pimp setup.
Next street, make it right.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
I think I want to know what the hell is going on before we go too close to this whatever's up.
Hey, I actually have a date that I'm, it's no bullshit. It's just,
And here's $100.
Thank you, baby.
So, hey, stay safe. What do your parents think about this?
Mom was a hoe. My dad was clearly her pimp, but she left when she got pregnant with me. They knew kind of, sort of, this was what I was going to do.
Hey, thank you so
guys.
Much. Stay
nice
safe.
Thank you guys.
Have a good night.
Have a good one.
Have a good day. Do you think she was more scared than we were?
Yes.
Yeah, bro.
But when she was texting whoever.
Then you sitting in the seat behind Shad and had a pancake on for? Yeah, chip for real.
I'm so sorry. I'm not trying to set you guys up or nothing like that.
What kills me is this. You meet Baby from the Chicago video. You meet Maya from this video. Like, she was cool. She was sweet. She was pretty. Like, what is she doing out here, dude? Like, she could do so much. Like,
it's crazy they're out here at 9 a.m. just getting ready to...
That is shocking. Please consider supporting the Patreon. YouTube's gonna demonetize this. And I wanna keep making fantastic videos for you guys.
How you doing?
I got $100. I'm just looking to ask you questions about your life. Can I ask you this? It's cold out. How are you staying warm right now?
Shaking. I'm dancing.
Stay safe.
Right, you too.
Oh, she's getting a customer right now.
So this is live action, folks. I got an idea. Feel free to say no, okay? So here's the pitch I got. I got $100. I have ski masks too. No? Is it, just because you don't want to be on camera? How much are we talking?
$100 not enough?
You're fleecing me right now, dude. All I say is this, is stay safe. I hope you have a good day, okay? Take care. Netflix, Hulu, any of these streaming platforms. I got stuff that YouTube won't let me show. Let's talk business.
Keegan, what do you think your mother would say if she knew what you were doing right now?
Oh, dude. I don't even want to think about that.
But yeah, what would your mother say?
She'd be pissed.
Should I call my mom and tell her what I'm doing? Yeah.
Yes.
Hey.
Hey, is this a good time to talk?
Not really. I'm in a church right now.
Here's one thing you need to do before buying anything online. Don't spend another dime on Amazon until you watch this first. Watch this.
How you doing? I got something to run by you. I'm a documentary filmmaker, and I just want to ask you questions. We'll spin the block, and I got $100 for you.
Okay.
Is that cool?
Y'all not gonna do no weird shit, right?
No.
Nah.
You not the cop?
No.
Touch my eyes, just so I know. Alright.
But hop in this side, okay?
Look, you recording already? You doing the most?
He's recording me, he can't. I'm gonna ask you questions, we'll spin the block, and I got $100 for you.
Okay.
Is that cool?
Y'all not gonna do no weird shit, right?
No.
Nah.
You not the cop?
No.
Touch my eyes, just so I know.
Tommy, you ain't been out here before, bro. Did this smile of a nigga that happy right now? Did this nigga right here happy right now, bro? You ain't never been out here before. All right, Tom.
All right.
But hop in this side, okay?
Look, you recording already? You doing the most?
He's recording me. He can't see you right now. How would you describe yourself in 3 words?
A bad chaser, outgoing. A hustler.
Are you usually out in mornings? I would imagine nights a little bit better, huh?
That's what they all say, but no. I mean, nighttime is just more of a fucking fashion show.
I guess there's probably less competition in the morning.
I mean, to me, there's no competition because I'm me.
Yeah.
I don't have to get fully naked, ass naked, wear stilettos all day, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
To get my bag compared to these bitches. They gotta be ass naked all day, morning, night, and not collecting nothing.
Mm.
And honestly, the customers I've come across when I actually, like, dress up, heels, and lingerie, they don't like it.
Yeah.
They'd rather me in regular clothes.
And what's the most popular thing people ask for?
I mean, it's different heads. Sometimes they want me to dance. Sometimes they want sex.
What's the weirdest request a client's ever had?
I mean, you get tricks. They want you to shit on them, piss on them.
What?
Beat them, all type of crazy shit. So,
really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Man, what the... Tommy, stop acting like you ain't know that shit, nigga. Talking about really. Let me find out she's talking about you, bro.
Actually, like, dress up, heels, and lingerie, they don't like it.
Yeah.
They'd rather me in regular clothes.
And what's the most popular thing people ask for?
I mean, it's different heads. Sometimes they want me to dance. Sometimes they want sex.
What's the weirdest request a client's ever had?
I mean, you get tricks. They want you to shit on them, piss on them.
What?
Beat them.
That nigga been out here before, bro. Hey, that is some weird. That's weird though. I ain't gonna lie, fool. Some of y'all in nigga weird. Don't leave the video now, nigga. You ain't embarrassed, nigga. We can't see you. I know.
Yeah, I think creepy shit. So yeah.
Really? Mm-hmm. Is there a stereotype about the Johns? Like, are they older? Are they younger? Are they white? Are they like, what are the, what's the profile of a John?
I'm not a fan of black Johns.
Why is that?
They too much. I can't finesse them.
What would you say your childhood was like?
Great.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Dang, she said great.
Of course.
What do they think about it?
I mean, what can I do? They not paying my bills.
If you could do anything in the world, like, what's a dream job to you?
I got a lot, but I want to be a fashion designer.
Yeah.
I'm into fashion.
Is this
fashion and dancing. I want to own my own strip club one day.
So. Oh, yeah? Do you enjoy having sex a lot?
No, not at all.
Does it get old?
I don't like having sex at all. Like, I'm not turned on. Like, some bitches love this shit. They enjoy getting fucked by tricks, not me.
Have you ever had a dangerous experience? A dangerous.
Just imagine y'all out there paying for a female that don't even like nothing she doing, bro. That crazy.
Encounter.
Oh, hell yeah.
Walk me through a story.
We get in the car. He's like, okay, yeah, we're just gonna go to my office. It's right here down the street around the corner. But I'm looking like, it's black as fuck out here. There's no police outside. Why do we need to go to your office? You got this big ass truck. So I'm like, you know, no, it's cool, it's okay. So as I'm finna get out the car, he still touch me. So I tell him like, hey, can you stop touching me? So as I'm getting out, he gets his hand and he just like gropes my titties and shit. So I have my phone, I turned around and I cracked them. I cracked them, this dude gets out the fucking car, starts chasing me down, has a fucking gun and all type of shit. I was like, what the fuck? Like, I was running for my life.
Are you happy?
I am happy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And how would you say your mental health is?
It's good, it's good.
Well, thank you for talking with us. I hope you stay safe. Have a great day. Do you want to keep that mask or is that not your style?
I'll keep it.
Okay,
I'll remember it. What was your name?
Tommy.
Tommy.
Okay. Tommy G on you.
Gang, you just grabbed her hand, her right hand at that. Shot, folks, she been out here all night, fool. You know what I mean? Testicles you just touched, bro. Bro, you just touched all kind of shit, bro. Shot just told she getting chased with bats, fucking lawnmowers or guns and shit. Man, you know what she been through, bro? You gotta chill, bro.
So y'all from Chicago?
We're from Milwaukee.
Period. Okay, I'm gonna have to come out there one day. See you guys later.
Have a good one. Mission accomplished. Keegan killed it behind the wheel. Miguel killed it behind the camera. We're always just fascinated by people and how people live such interesting or different lives. And I feel for these women, man.
For sure.
Thanks for joining us on this episode. We'll see you guys
next week. Hey, for sure. Like, and they come from a young nigga, bro. Like, I'm young, fool. So I understand. Like, it sound all live and cool and all that. Ain't no wrong with having. I've been cussing all video, but I'm trying not to get demonetized. Ain't nothing wrong with having 304s. Ain't no wrong with having a few options, like a little few females you chop it up with, talk to, but it's different when you got females out here doing this, damaging their body and just ruining their life, bro, at a young age. They don't even know that 5-10 years from now, everything is gonna be different. You're gonna be in a different scenario. You're gonna be in different shoes. You're gonna start a different space in life, and you done ruined your life for like 5 years. You done put wear and tear on your body. Like it's like when they doing that, they living 2 years at a time. When on their body, you get what I'm saying? So the wear and tear is double, bro. It ain't like you just out here experiencing life, may go on a date, start talking to a dude and then catch a body. Well, you getting hit every day, every night, different people. Like your body just getting worn, tore down. Mentally, you getting torn apart. Like these females don't know they work, fool. Like, and it ain't even no sucker. You ain't gotta be no soft nigga. That just real talk, bro. Like you talk to a female, let her know it ain't even gotta be this. Let's say it ain't for dudes, it's for you, bro. Go get a job, stack your money. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's just me. But the pimp on the other hand, bro, making money. He ain't trying to hear none of that. I feel him though. I mean, it's like, bro, it's Monopoly. They just playing the game. You feel me? But anyway, man, y'all drop a like on the video, subscribe to the channel if y'all rock with it. If y'all want me to react to some more bro videos, y'all send them to me or comment in the comment section. I'm definitely gonna tune in to them. If you made it this far, comment we still here or locked in. One of the two, I'm gonna be in the comments reacting and dropping likes and talking back to people. I appreciate the love and support. And we finna go crazy, man. Make sure y'all subscribe to the channel. I'm on the subathon right now, try to drop a video every day for y'all. And we finna rock out. Gotta bring up some more videos, so I gotta study. Just get them in.